and welcome to today's Meet the Expert vlog for Vanderlande. I am Jessica von Krausbergen, and I'm Product Manager for Airport Services. Today, we're going to explore data-driven maintenance. Well-maintained assets are integral for seamless operations. In baggage operations, all assets need to work together to ensure that every bag reaches their flight. In today's episode, we will explore how maintenance is evolving towards a more holistic, data-driven approach. We will see how this can benefit airport operations. We've learned from our customers that they value operations that are flexible, predictable, and guaranteed. That also means maintenance needs to be reliable and worry-free. At the same time, it's essential to balance cost and value at the desired performance. That's why we adapt an holistic maintenance approach tailored specifically to each airport. In our approach, we not only consider asset criticality and system design, but we also leverage multiple maintenance strategies. Let's talk to my colleague Valerie to learn more about our data-driven maintenance solutions. Hey, Valerie.
Hey, Jessica.
How are you doing?
Good, you?
Good. So we've been seeing a big shift in calendar-based maintenance towards data-driven maintenance. Can you tell us more about our maintenance strategies?
Yes, of course. So at Vanderlande, we offer different maintenance solutions that we tailor to our customers. And all of these solutions together form our data-driven maintenance toolbox. Now I can run you through them a bit.
Yeah.
So we've got usage-based maintenance, which is based on maintenance counters. So here we look at runtime hours to determine if we need to check an asset. You've got condition-based maintenance, which is really about sensors, whether they are handheld or fixed, and predefined thresholds to trigger the maintenance. And then you've got predictive maintenance, where we combine data with smart adaptive algorithms to determine if we need to look at an individual asset before an issue occurs.
Okay. Predictive maintenance has been quite a buzzword in the industry. Can you tell me about what qualifies as predictive maintenance?
Yes, of course. So let's start with how we at Vanderlande define predictive maintenance. For us, it involves data and then using smart adaptive algorithms that can predict if an issue will occur at your asset. So looking at the data first, this can be both internal data sources, such as an LMS, a local motor starter, or external sensors. Then that data is fed into the data analysis, so algorithms, specifically machine learning. This is applied on each individual asset, and it helps to determine over time what the behavior, the normal behavior is of an asset. And so with that, the algorithm can then also detect when it starts to deviate from this norm.
Can you tell me why it's important to analyze the assets individually?
Yes. So each asset behaves differently. For example, the vibration you get from a conveyor that is bolted onto the floor is different from the vibration of a conveyor that's bolted onto a platform. So you want to take that into account. Now, once everything's been analyzed, we can visualize it. I have an image of that. Let me grab that for you. So as you can see, we can then show in the VIA Insights dashboards how your asset has been performing, what we notice in terms of anomalies. And if an anomaly is detected, we can also send automatic alerts to the maintenance team so they can get to work on this.
Wow, this is really interesting. Can you tell me a little bit about why we wouldn't just go with predictive maintenance and rather adopt multiple maintenance strategies?
Yeah. So predictive maintenance is a great advancement. It's super beneficial, very good, but it's also a lot of buzz around it. And in the end, what matters most is that we have a maintenance strategy that really meets the needs of each individual airport that we are supporting, and so that they get the most value out of their investment. And what we often see then is that it makes more sense to have a combination of predictive maintenance, usage-based maintenance, and condition-based maintenance.
How do we determine what maintenance strategies to employ across the system?
Well, one key tool for this is the criticality assessment that helps us determine how to prioritize the assets. And then there are also other aspects to take into account. For example, predictive maintenance is well suited for assets that are in hard to reach locations, where normally maintenance would take a lot of time and effort. The bottom line, though, is that it is essential that we have a dialogue with the customer so we can create a holistic view that really meets the customer's needs and that makes most use of the solutions that we have.
A Another thing to consider is the skill set change in maintenance teams needed in order to transition to a data-driven approach. Predictive maintenance requires maintenance teams to learn how to interpret data. This is important to respond to anomaly detection. This is also handy for younger technicians, where they're able to use this to validate the effectiveness of their work. However, simply adding predictive maintenance tools is not enough. We must integrate them smartly. We will learn more about this after our lunch. Bon appetit!
Enjoy!
Are you ready to call Mark?
Yes, let's.
Okay, let's do it. Hey Mark, how are you doing?
Good, how are you?
Doing really well. It's really nice to have you here for the Meet the Expert vlog. I'm here with Valerie.
Hey Mark.
Hi Valerie.
So Mark, at the site that you're working, in 2024 they introduced our predictive maintenance solution. Can you tell me what made that interesting for this customer?
Yeah, sure. So for our customer, it's a top priority to offer a seamless passenger journey every time. However, as at every airport, even minor disruptions can impact baggage operations. That's why we proposed a predictive maintenance solution to the customer, and after a trial, we've rolled it out on critical assets. We gain more insights into asset health and can proactively schedule maintenance checks outside of operational hours. And this is a great improvement to ensure dependable operations and minimize disruptions. It's been such a success that we are currently planning an expansion of the rollout.
That's really great to hear. Can you tell me more about critical assets?
Yeah, sure. We perform criticality assessments using our own Vanderlande tool based on criteria such as health and safety, operational impact, and cost. We categorize areas of the system into three criticality levels, A, B, and C. For predictive maintenance, this helps us decide which assets to focus on and to ensure the solution is cost effective. It's important to note that we regularly update this analysis. Factors like bag volumes can influence how the system is used, and also that means the criticality changes over time.
So how's the team's experience been so far?
It's been very positive overall. There was some hesitation in the beginning until the team got more familiar with the output. It's understandable that it took some time to learn together with a solution and create a feedback loop. It's an ongoing process for the whole team. For instance, there was this one case where we received an alert on one of our reclaim carousels. But just by visual inspection, nothing was apparent. However, when we opened the asset, we found a track wear strip had worked loose. We would never have detected this so early without predictive maintenance and avoided a high impact fault.
What do moments like this mean for you and the team?
Moments like this help to build the trust with the alerts. One of our duty engineers said it's like having 2,500 technicians on site looking at the assets 24/7.
Well, that's good to hear. So have you been able to change the maintenance strategy so far?
Partly, yes. The solution provides valuable insights on the assets. However, it has limitations on what it can detect. We keep learning what can be predicted reliably and how it impacts physical inspections. We still perform the visual inspections, but we are looking to reduce the frequency and make them more focused. So overall, adapting the maintenance strategy is an ongoing process.
Thanks, Mark. We'll see you next time.
Bye-bye.
The next step after predictive maintenance is prescriptive maintenance, where the solution predicts failure and identifies probable costs. This will be another great advancement, making maintenance more reliable and efficient, leading to predictable operations. While manual tasks will always be part of our maintenance workflow, we can make them more efficient and smarter. I really enjoyed taking you along on our data-driven maintenance strategy today. See you next time.